Hi, welcome to this new video tutorial. After a long time, I'm going to get back today on Blender and I will show you how to do basic navigations in Blender 2.92. And it can be in any version of Blender. So this video tutorial will be mostly for beginner. I assume you know nothing about Blender and you are getting started, and sometimes it may be confusing. So I'm doing this video tutorial. I'm not an expert, but I'm just trying to give you a tips. So here the mouse that I have is this mouse, like this mouse with two buttons. This left one and the right one, and in the middle here you have this ball here which we're going to use to for zooming and other purposes in Blender. But mostly here we are going to use this left one to select here. So let's get back and start our application. So we have Blender here which is already installed. I assume you have already done so. Then the first time we are presented with this windows, don't get scared. So what you have to do now is to select any part. If you want to read anything here, you can do that, but you just want to do the basic navigations, introduce you to the basic navigation. So click any area, empty area here. Then that one is gone. In the beginning, we have this cube, this legendary cube that we have in the middle. So how to get started? So one thing that you can do is that you may read some useful informations here below. So if I move again my mouse here, so whenever you want to select the objects, we are going to use, remember, the left. We are going to use this left buttons of our mouse. So and you can also do that, we use the left button. So if we use the left button, we go to the objects here, we select, then you can see the object is selected. If you want to deselect it, click any empty area. Then you may also read that here. I'm just going to do a small things demonstrations. Suppose we just take a current screenshot. I just want to show something. So by default here, you can see at the bottom here, you have some useful informations here. Like if you want to select, you can use this left buttons, or you can double click here for box select, and the middle for rotating the view. And this, so here at the bottom here, you may directly read some useful informations here with shortcuts and other. So that's it. I've already shown you, we can select our object, we can deselect it. That is it. So the next thing that we want to do is after we are able to select our objects, then we go to this viewpoint here. You see this coordinates here. What can we do there? If we select, we come here and select that, we can see the view is changed to top orthographic mode. And this top orthographic, you can read that information here. And if we click select Y, then it go back, then we have different mode. If you click on X here, we can see that we have different positions. We click here, you have different positions. So if you click again on X here, then we click on Z, we are back to this one. We click on Y, now we keep press on suppose Y here, and we can turn it. We can see here, we can move our mouse, the cursor, as far as we are moving, then we can get different viewing positions. You can see here, this is just by keeping the button press here in one of these coordinate, and then move it as you want. We select here X, then we can move it. we can move it, we can move it, we can move it. So here, your imagination is your limit. You can do whatever you want to do here. Yeah. And then after that, you are going to see some points. Those points, those 3 points will be this one here, moving the view. If we keep these things here selected, this icon here, move the view selected, you can see this end icon, we keep it selected, then here we can move the objects in the view. We can move it, we can move it, we can move it, we can move it. So yeah, that is it. Then after we move it, then it's gone. Then we may also have here this to toggle the camera view. And the shortcut, you can see it below. The shortcut is numpad 0. If you have a keyboard with a numpad, then you can press 0 there. Then if you select there, here we have the camera view. So you can see the camera perspective of the objects. This is what we get. And if you select again, then we get back to this one. Then here, we can switch between the perspective and the orthographic projections, or using the numpad 5, but I don't want to go to the shortcuts and so on. So if you select here, you can see that the view change. Here it is the user orthographic mode, and here is the perspective mode. Here you can see the perspective mode, and then this and that. So depending on what we are going to do later, this is how we can do that. Then if you want to zoom in, then you can move, remember, this bolt here in the middle of your mouse. This one, we can move this one to zoom. If you just select the object, we can zoom in. Just you can do it on yourself here. We do that, right? We do this one and here. We move towards our objects here, and we can come, for example, here to the view, then frame selected to centralize our object in the middle. I can repeat it. I zoom in, then we move. Suppose our object was here. You want to bring it to the center. So what we are going to do here is to go to the view, come here, frame selected, then we have our object in the view, in the middle. Then, right, we have our object in the middle, then we can zoom in, we can zoom in, we can zoom in, we can zoom in. So these are some of the basic things that you can start with these navigations. I wanted to show you only these things so that you can know how you can select and change in different view from here, and know what different this tool mean. If you want to move our object, we can move it to wherever we want, right? We just select on that, press that icon, end icon, we press it, then move it as we want. Also, we have the camera view here and this perspective orthographic switch, right? So I hope that this small video tutorial will be useful to you, and then it will allow you to get started with this tutorial. Get started with Blender. It's a long journey, but I'm just trying to bring you some tips that you may find. There are indeed a lot of tutorial out there, but you don't know which one sometimes can be helpful. So if you like it, do not hesitate to subscribe to my channel. And then if you have any problems, you can also drop your comments, and I will react as soon as possible. So stay tuned for the next tools. Then bye.